greatest, Lily, the greatest egg in the squirrels.
Greatest? And I
hold on. Who has the milk and full? Hold on, Nick, just grabs and just doing something.
I want this!
Bobby, I'm gonna turn this off. I'm pressing turn off for you.
Stop! Don't touch that!
Bobby.
What?
I'm getting that!
Swimming in it.
tiny bomb. That's so annoying. Oh, so many kids in the like button.
He hit himself.
Yes, today we have prepared for you the top 300 and Mama's compilation. You should stay till the end, because the best clips are at the end of this video.
Hello there. Do you have a gun? Oh, he has a gun now. Wait, you go for the gun. There's a gun, oh, buddy. Hey! Don't whip out my gun. Don't whip out that...
That's on a YouTube show.
How about this?
Well, you're watching a girl show.
I'm watching a girl show?
It's a Sean show. They're trending now. I'm not gonna make it, and I do like it. That teddy bear's annoying me.
I hate it. I think that.
This is no one.
Oh, she's
brilliant. Use my past and my memories as a weapon. On the other Hi there, What girls think when they're walking home from a date?
Oh, that was such a nice boy. He was really cute. He had a great smile, and I had a really fun time. I hope he likes me just as much as I like him.
What boys think when they're walking home from a date?
All right, if I step on any of these cracks, I'm definitely gay.
Come on over here. Come on over here. Please, let me off. Come on, Alex. Come on, you're not gonna like me. You're a fake or fraud.
That's a business I need.
Go back outside.
What's wrong? What's wrong? You got a late pass? Late pass.
I'm the teacher and I'm a student. Now if you gotta stay in the office, give me your pass.
No, it's my classroom.
Oh, my bad. Did I ask all that?
No.
Shield and zero health, totaling to 47, which went against the 147 total we thought before. Now for the final test, we did it with 25 shield and 21 health. Now we ended up getting 79 health and 48 shield. So from this we can see that the zero point will get you to 100 health like a medkit, and around 47 to 48 shield.
Can you get my shield back? It's like American
Oh my gosh!
TV?
No.
Can I have a new laptop?
No.
Can I have a PlayStation?
No.
Can I get the new iPhone?
No.
Can I get the new Samsung?
No.
Can I have a toothbrush?
What do you think, I'm made of money?
Well, isn't that what mom stands for?
No, it doesn't matter.
Oh, my.
My bedtime's just at 8. But I don't go to bed.
Dude, you just can't look into someone's window like that.
Oh yeah? Watch me.
Never mind, let's get out.
Face way in 2 seconds, like he'll build all of that. Like, so basically, you just gotta press leave massively at your stake. If you shoot Deadpool, he'll build you an entire yacht, and this one's safe, right? It's not like face way. He has a 330 yacht, you can go chill with him, he's a nice guy. He even has some beer, Coca Cola, Pepsi, and all that. Like, you can just take some. He even has a Statue of Liberty and fully working toilet. You can take the biggest dump. Oh, never mind, there's another man.
Okay, whatever.
And finally, we got Ice King, one t-shirt, who will literally bring back the Season 7 castle. And please don't enter, because he's gonna be hella drunk and he has the sword.
Yeah. This is America! Don't get too slippin' up!
You have to stop drinking. You were so drunk last night at my party.
No, I wasn't. What do you mean?
You threw my hamster out the window saying, Pikachu, I choose you!
When you activate a bounty on a shapeshift, you just use the bounty on the shapeshift to skin.
Once she goes back to her regular form.
Thank you.
for you.
Yes, Johnny.
Do you love me?
No, Johnny.
Hey, guys. I'm back from the bathroom.
Welcome back. You can just take a seat.
I just told you about the spot.
The baby Yoda back thing will disappear when you put on the Mandalorian jetpack. You can damage someone in a car with the Ammon sniper rifle's melee attack. You can activate a gas can in an enemy's hand with the Ammon sniper rifle's melee. You can cancel any momentum with the Ammon sniper rifle's melee.
Charlie D'Amelio, is that you, Charlie D'Amelio?
No! Don't do it! No! No! I'm afraid you are!
Chicken.
my scarf! Shut the fuck up! Blue panel! Suit! D-box! Bobby!
Taking some me time, or making some me time. Stealing a moment, or enjoying it.
Bobby, no. It's not modded. Bobby, no. It's not modded. I need to erase it. Bobby, I don't have a jetpack, so I can't speak ill. And then when I have a jetpack, I have 100 health.
So we all know every sport has a bully. At my school, our bully was the greatest. Everyone was scared of him because he was known to enjoy beating people up. Sometimes, it seemed like even adults were scared of him, too. I was terrified of Brayden. So I just got smart, became his friend. It wasn't always easy being Brayden's friend, though. He punched me for no reason. I had to laugh at all of his jokes where he'd give me the look. And he always ate my lunches. But it was worth it. At least I didn't have to worry about him beating me up like other kids did. Oh, one day, Brayden and our classmate Zai started teasing each other. Zai jokes were so funny. I chuckled at one of them. I looked at Brayden and Brayden was giving me the look. He told me to come here and I did because he's my friend. Then he put a pencil on his shoulder and said, knock the pencil off. I thought it was a joke, so I knocked the pencil off. You know what that means? I'ma beat you up after school. My eyes lit up. Notice he didn't say we're gonna fight. He said he's gonna beat me up. Oh, he's confident. When the last bell rung, I was the first person out of school. I hopped on my bike and pedaled like I stole something. After Brayden's friend, he's gonna beat me up. I enjoyed it for a whole week. I heard he was getting more and more mad every day. And I just can't understand. Why does Brayden want to beat me up? I didn't do anything to him. He knocked the pencil off. It must have been his favorite pencil. So I thought, hey, I'll buy him new pencils, and then we can be friends again. So the next day after lunch, we were outside, and Brayden started walking up to me. Who are you getting new pencils? My friends later told me that when he got up to me, he said, are you? I didn't hear him because I was reaching in the bag to get the pencils. When I looked up, he punched me in my face. I was already on the ground, so all I could do was cover my face.
Oh, somebody help me!
The teacher was scared of Brayden, so he called security. They finally got him off of me, and he was suspended from school. I was treated like a hero because now everyone can walk around the school in peace. That is until Brayden's suspension is over. We all knew, in a matter of days, Brayden would be back. The day after, one of my friends sent me a YouTube link, and guess what it was? Me getting beat up by Brayden. The only person I remember being that close was Zai. So I gave him a call. You recorded the beatdown? You don't remember, do you? When Brayden was walking up to you and you were digging through your bag, he said to me, take your phone off and start recording. And you know, what Brayden says goes. Okay, but did you have to send it to him? Yes. When they were walking him away, he said, send me that video or next time, it's gonna be you. So I get that. Zai had to do what he had to do. So the next day, I went to the principal so he could get Brayden to take down the video. But he was all like, I'm not talking to Brayden. What, so he can beat me up too? Oh my goodness. Is there anyone that's not scared of this kid? At this point, the video's going viral.
I want this video down.
Hello, what's this? Under the video, I see a button that says report. And when I clicked it, it read, Brayden said we can't take this video down. He had YouTube scared, so I just gave up. So a few days after Brayden's suspension, I heard my doorbell ring. I looked out the window, and it was Brayden.
Ah, he's at my house.
How does he know where I live? Hello?
Open up the door, Desmond. It's Brayden.
I know Desmond here.
I know it's you, Desmond. Principal gave me an address. Open up the door. Don't make me ask twice.
I had no choice but to open up the door. Oh, hey, Brayden. Kicked any butts lately?
That's why I'm here.
Oh, my goodness. He's gonna beat me up at my own house.
You have a studio, don't you?
Yeah.
Good. I need to record a song. Brayden in the booth, getting loose, always being tough. Better like these guards, cause if not, I'ma beat you up. Like I did the kid that knocked the pistol off my shoulder. I beat him so bad he beat himself till it was over. If that boy listening, I really want you to know. I'm the type to come and diss you in your own studio. So to the kid that got me suspended, you better watch your back, cause it still ain't finished. I'll shoot you.
So I'm nervous this morning because Brayden's suspension is over. While my dad made his coffee, he would turn on the radio.
Have you heard that new song? It's called Knock the Pencil Off My Shoulder. It's by a new artist named Brayden the Bully. And we got him on the phone right now. Brayden, how dare you come up with this song?
It was easy. I just beat up this boy at school, made a song about it, and get this. I'm recording the song at his house.
Oh, he's recording the song at his house, though. Let's hear a little bit of it.
Brayden in the booth.
Get me out of here.
Better like these cars, cause if
I got a lot.
I get to school, I run right into Brayton.
All right, Brayton, I'm ready.
Nah, man, that song we recorded just went double platinum. Today, I'm not gonna beat you up.
That ain't gonna make me miserable.
Brayton started tripping me up the stairs, scaring me around corners, and planned on stealing my bike. So during recess, I loosened up my handlebars. After school, he tried to steal my bike, and he fell.
Dad, man, I'm gonna beat you up tomorrow.
Night.
Today we're playing touch football in gym class, so get ready.
Our gym teacher starts telling us who we're going to be guarding, and of course I got matched up with Brayton. Please, please, anybody but him.
I'm sorry, Desmond. Brayton wanted to be matched up with you, and you know what Brayton says goes. The teams are set, Desmond.
Oh my goodness, I already know what that guy's planning. It's touch football, but he's going to tackle me. Every time they would say hype, Brayton would start running at me like a bull.
Oh, wait till I get you.
I'm sure the teacher seen what was going on, but, you know, another teacher scared of Brayton. It would be a timeout, but he would still come after me. I'm over here drinking water, and he's still coming after me. Tying my shoe, still coming after me. And I almost got the ball. He's still coming after me. The bell rung, and gym class was over, so I stopped running. But Brayton didn't, and he tackled me.
That's for when I fell off the bike when I tried to steal
it. It just seems like he's never going to give me a break. So I finally accepted the fact that Brayton just doesn't like him. If I see him while I'm walking up the stairs, I just get ready because I know he's going to trick me. Wait a minute. He didn't trick me. Well, I know when I walk around the corner, he's going to scare me. Wait, what? Well, it's lunchtime, so I know he's going to want my food. Okay, what's going on? What's wrong with Brayton? Are you feeling okay?
I'm great. Why do you ask?
You just seem a little different today, that's all.
Well, last night, I really got some good sleep. But what do you mean by I'm acting different?
Well, you usually kick my butt every day.
What? I would never. You must got me mixed up with another Brayton.
Yeah, you're right. I don't know who this new Brayton is, but I like him. He's laughing more. He's not tripping me up the stairs. This Brayton is really. Well, I can get used to this. The next day, I seen Brayton. I was like, what's up, Brayton?
Why are you calling my name like we friends or something?
Oh, my goodness.
You must have didn't get no sleep. I'm so sorry, Brayton. I don't know what I was thinking. Yeah, I don't know what you thinking.
I guess you didn't get no sleep last night.
Brayton don't sleep. Get out of my face.
Yup, Brayton's back. So one day when I got to school, I saw this kid. I waved, started walking up the stairs, and he tripped me.
Good one. Desmond, meet my brother Nathan.
I didn't know Brayton had a little brother. Hey, little man.
Nathan, he just called you little.
Are you going to take that?
Turns out, Layton is Brayton's big brother. I just ran away. I thought Brayton was bad, but Layton was ruthless. He was scaring teachers, beating up students, and just acting crazy.
What do you think about my brother?
Oh, he's your brother, all right.
He coolest. After school, I see Layton stuck in the highest part of the gym. I asked him if he needed help, but he said no. So I left. The next day when I see Layton and Brayton, Brayton looked a little angrier than usual.
So you just gonna leave my brother in the jungle gym?
Oh my god, did this little short wannabe Brayton just lie on me? He said he didn't need help.
Did you ask for help?
What? No, he didn't.
You called my big brother a liar?
I can't win this battle. So I just gave him my lunch money and said I'm sorry.
Works every time.
So Brayton had a girlfriend, and surprisingly, she was very nice. But sometimes she was a little too nice. Every time Brayton turned his head around, she would flirt with me. She would blow kisses, wink her eye at me, and put up the heart sign. What is she doing? If Brayton sees her, who knows what he's going to do? So I would just turn around because I didn't want any problem. Well, Brayton wasn't at school one day, and I seen his girlfriend at recess. And she said,
I like you, Desmond.
I like you too, Brittany.
No, Desmond. I like you. You look like Neo, and I like Neo.
She trying to get me beat up? Brayton would turn me into a pretzel if he heard her talking like that. I think I should go. She grabbed my hand and kissed me.
What's going on here?
Turns out Brayton was at the doctor's, and he was still coming to school.
Desmond came up to me and kissed me.
She just straight up lied on me. Brayton came up to me and punched me in my eye. So today, we were being paired up for a science project. I don't know how this keeps on happening, but I got paired up with Brayton. Mr. Stander, can I work by myself? Never mind. Working with Brayton was the worst. He didn't do anything. He made me do all the work. I did the research. I picked the flowers. I came up with the presentation. All he did was bog me around and stand there. So on the day of the presentation, Brayton comes up to me and says,
the presentation better be done.
It is. Just follow my lead.
Who are you talking to?
Myself. Talking to myself. It was our turn to go up and our presentation was a song.
Carbon dioxide plus water and light energy equals glucose. In oxygen, in that maze, photosynthesis.
Ooh, that was good. Which one of y'all was singing?
Me, I was singing.
Are you serious? No way the teacher's gonna buy that. Wow, Brayton, you sing better than Desmond. You get an A plus. For you, Desmond, you just get a plain old A.
Of course.
So today, we got a new student. His name was Bernard.
sit anywhere you want, Bernard.
He sat next to me by the end of the class. We were friends. So at recess, Brayton came up to us and asked us for some money.
Give me some money.
Oh, Bernard, just give him your money. Bernard said, I don't think so.
Since you're new, I'm going to give you one more chance.
I said, give me your money. No. Oh, man, Bernard's about to get beat up on his first day. I can't watch.
Huh?
Oh, that was bad.
Come on, Desmond. Let's go to class. I don't know what Bernard did to Brayton, but anytime he seen me with him, he just left me alone. Why does Brayton hate you so much? Man, I don't know. We used to be friends, but then one day he asked me to knock the pencil off his shoulder, and I did, and he hated me ever since. So at recess, Bernard walked up to Brayton and pulled out a pencil. Knocked the pencil off. Brayton knocked the pencil off. Then Bernard took off his shirt and Brayton ran away. Turns out today was Bernard's last day because he was transferring again. You can't be scared of Brayton. You gotta be brave.
Yeah, alright.
Today's May 8th, my birthday. I'm about to have the best day at school. Well, I thought I was. Brayton made this day the worst day of my life. He popped my birthday balloon, ate some of my birthday cookies, and ruined my birthday song.
Happy birthday to Brayton. Happy birthday to Brayton.
Then he ate my McDonald's birthday sandwich.
Oh, that's it. I can't stand you, Brayton. I don't like you. You're so mean. You're nothing but a bully.
So after school, the doorbell rang, and it was Brayton. Let me guess, you're here to give me my 12 birthday hits, aren't you?
Oh, birthday hits, funny.
Brayton came over to give me another McDonald's sandwich. I don't understand.
You were right at school. We used to be friends. I don't know what happened.
Brayton and I just chilled on the porch and talked about when we used to be friends. Like, why did you get so mad when I knocked that stupid pencil off your shoulder?
That pencil's not stupid. You're stupid. We're not friends no more.
And just like that, we were back to square one. Happy birthday to me. Look at me. With that big old smile. I was happy because I was finally chosen to be the school safety. The school safety had really cool responsibilities, like raising the school flag, monitoring the hallways, and just having the respect of all the students. Well, all the students minus Brayton the bully. He treated me like I didn't have the safety bag. I'd get to school and he'd be raising the flag already. Brayton, that's my job.
What you gonna do about it?
He never had a hall pass. Brayton, I don't mean to start no trouble, but do you have a hall pass? He just didn't respect me.
Oh, yeah.
Brayton, that's mine.
I'm the safety. I'm the safety. I'm the safety. Where's your hall pass, little boy?
So I went to the principal and told him Brayton.
Let me show you something, Desmond.
Brayton has been a safety for the last 6 years.
Anytime, and I mean anytime, we choose someone else, he just takes their badge. 1 week I was a safety, and he just took my badge. No one can control him, Desmond. Run! Run!
And I ran for my life. So once again, my school was having a talent show. My friend Calista and I decided to sing a duet. Throughout the day, we tried to rehearse between classes.
There's no air, no air. Got me out here in the water so deep.
Oh, Desmond, you sound like a little girl.
Anytime we were practicing, Brayton was messing us up. Brayton, here's $20. Just leave us alone.
Oh, yeah, give me that.
So at the talent show, there was no sign of Brayton.
Tell me how I'm supposed to breathe with no air. Can't live, can't breathe without air. It's hard with you whenever you ain't there. There's no air, no air.
Got me out here in the water so deep. Got me out here gonna be without breath. If you ain't here, I just can't breathe. There's no air, no air.
Brayton cut off my mic and set him apart. The judges thought it was me singing, and we lost the talent show. All because of Brayton and his stupid shenanigans. So one Saturday, I heard a knock at my door, and it was my good friend Bernard. He was in town visiting his grandma, and I told him all about Brayton the school bully. Brayton is still messing with you. I told you to be brave.
I'm not that strong, Bernard.
Have you been using that app I showed you?
Oh, the home workout app?
Link to the app is on my... Stop, Desmond, no more app. Are you serious? Brayton's gonna beat you up if you don't get strong. Come on, we got work to do. Bernard started training me, and let's just say, it wasn't easy. He had me doing all these workouts that I never heard of. He had me running miles and doing boxing drills for hours. Man, I can't do this. I quit.
You quit?
Don't you want to look like this so you can scare Brayton off? Then get up and stop being a weenie. After Bernard's intense training, I was ready. I was ready to face Brayton. The next day at school, I turned the corner and Brayton was there.
Look who it is. Ugly egghead.
Your mama.
What do you say to me?
Your mama.
Oh, you just got yourself beat up.
Yeah, that's what you think. Brayton swung at me and I skipped it. Then I hit him with a two-piece. My goodness, got him. And then he tried to tackle me.
Who do you think you can punch Brayton and get away with it?
I moved out the way and when he turned around, I punched him in the face.
Bernard would be so proud.
At this point, I just started doing everything Bernard taught me.
Okay, Jasmine, you win.
What was that, Brayton? I didn't hear you.
I said you win.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I couldn't believe it. I actually beat Brayton up. As I was walking away, Brayton snuck up behind me and hit me.
Nobody beat Brayton up.
Turns out, it was all a dream. Today, Brayton was mean as usual, but after school is when it all went down.
My bike! Where's my bike? It was right here!
Are you talking about the green and blue bike? Oh yeah, Brayton just took that.
What? Okay, you can eat my lunch. You can punch me in the face, but you cannot steal my blue and green bike!
So I didn't want any man to do it. I told my daddy. My dad was furious, so we hopped in the car and we drove to Brayton's house. I seen Brayton outside, so I walked up to him. Hey, Brayton, somebody told me that you took my bike.
What bike?
The blue and green one. You know, the one that you tried to steal before.
Oh, that bike. I didn't know you still wanted it. Come on, I'll take you to it.
So I followed Brayton to get my bike. Well, Brayton's not too bad after all.
Woo! That's my bike, bro! You want somebody to steal, old man?
No.
Desmond, get in this car! Got me over here messing with these crazy folks.
My bike!
Forget that bike!
So anytime we had to write an essay or we had tests, Brayton would copy off of me. And if the teacher noticed that our work was the same, I would have to take the fall.
Y'all papers are identical, which means one of y'all copied. Who copied?
It was me. I copied. If I tried to cover my answers, he would punch me. If I was done my test before him, he would tell me to sit down so he could finish copying. I even tried to move my seat one time, but Brayton was right there. I was over it, so I came up with the plan. One day, we were having a test, and I picked up two answer sheets. That way, I can circle the wrong answers on one sheet and the right answers on the other. It was so funny, because I could see Brayton copying my answers, and they were wrong! When the test was over, Brayton said,
"Give me that other answer sheet."
Other answer sheet? I don't know what you're talking about.
The jig is up, Desmond. I see the other answer sheet. Now give it to me.
What? Brayton, you're tripping.
One.
Brayton, I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't make me get to four.
Three. Okay, here.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
That's it. On Friday, I'm beating up Brayton. For real. Even worse than I did in my dream. So one day, our English teacher asked us to develop and for our new project. We had to come up with our own product and create a commercial for it. Me and my friend Calissa paired up, and Brayton didn't like that.
Desmond, you're my partner.
No, Brayton, you make me do all the work. You're on your own.
Who do you think you're talking to?
I'm talking to you.
Brayton, just leave us alone.
This ain't over.
Calissa came over to my house to work on the project. My product was called Spurs Burger Juice, and our commercial was like,
Burger Juice, better than root beer. Tasty great juice.
I do.
Okay, Brayton, go ahead.
Burger juice, better than root beer. A tasty grape juice.
Wait a minute, he stole our song. Oh, no, you didn't. Desmond, you failed for interrupting Brayton. Brayton, you get an A.
Nah, yeah.
So our principal would choose students to produce the morning news. And my friends, I and Brayton and myself were chosen. I was the anchor, so I was the gamer man. Brayton controlled the telephone.
I don't want to control this.
You're fucking idiot.
Nobody want to see your face in the morning?
You've been acting real tough lately.
Because I'm tired of your crap. You're always trying to boss somebody around.
Come over here and say that to my face.
And we're live in 3, 2, good morning, Lost Eye Bucket. Welcome to the news. My name is Desmond Dennis, and today is Wednesday, May 27th. We have a few announcements to help you prepare for your day. The weather today will be so hot that birds will be pulling worms out of the ground with abdomens. Lunch today will be crap as usual. The word of the day is doo-doo. And the quote of the day, lap out loud, the quote of the day is people say nothing is impossible, but I do nothing every day.
Oh, Desmond, Brayton, go up there.
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Brayton, and I would like to apologize for Desmond's rude behavior. For lunch, I'm going to be giving Desmond a knuckle sandwich.
So last night, I didn't get a lot of sleep, and I was falling asleep in every classroom. My teacher got so mad at me that he made me stand up in the back of the class. But that didn't help, I just leaned on the wall and fell asleep. During recess, I fell asleep on the jungle gym. The bell woke me up and I stood up. I tried to walk, but then I fell. Everyone started laughing at me. Turns out, Brayton tied my shoes together.
I got you.
Nah, that's it. I'm not taking any more of Brayton's crap. Hey, Brayton, knock the pencil off.
Oh, you wanna fight me?
All I gotta say is meet me at the park after school.
So you really wanna do this, huh?
Do you not remember half of the things you've done to me? You beat me up for no reason. You stole my bike twice. You tackled me in gym class. Made a diss track about me. Enough is enough.
Do you know who I am? I'm Brayton the Bully. Nobody can beat me up.
Don't say nobody, because my friend Bernard beat you up.
I'm done talking. You wanted to fight, so hit me.
I just kept staring at him, thinking about everything he's done to me.
I said hit me.
Before he could finish, my fist was in his face. He got back up like it didn't affect him.
Oh, this could be harder than I thought.
Then he put me in a headlock.
You really think you're gonna win? You think you're gonna win?
I got out of it. Then he tried to punch me, but I moved out the way. He tried to punch me again, but I moved out the way again.
So that's how Bernard beat him up.
Brain can only punch people when they're standing still.
Stop moving!
No, if you want to beat me up, you gotta catch me. He tried to tackle me, but I moved out the way. He tried to kick me, but he missed.
I said stay still!
He tried to hit me again, but his punches were getting slower.
I said stay still!
I beat up Brain without even touching him!
Okay, Desmond. Do it!
I looked at Brain, and I couldn't help but to feel sorry for him.
Nah, man, I'm not gonna do that.
After really talking to him, I learned that Brayton had it pretty rough at home. That's why he was so bad at school. We didn't become friends, but we respected each other. So after we graduated, I really haven't seen Brayton. But a couple of months ago, I went to a new barbershop, and I seen Brayton there.
What is he doing here?
I thought I would never, ever see him again. But there he was, with that stupid grin on his face. Even after the job, I'm still scared of him.
Oh, look who it is. Little egghead. Stuttering Stanley. The little boy that seemed like a little girl.
After all these years, he hasn't changed one bit.
Oh, so Brayton, you're a barber now.
Yeah, I like to cut the people's hair.
Good for you.
Get in my chair.
No, thank you, Brayton. He's gonna cut my hair.
I said, get in my chair.
Brayton, you wanna kick me? I'm kicked off the
floor. I said, get in my chair.
All right. Brayton, I'm a singer now, so take your time with my hair, please.
I got you.
I was so focused on trying to get to level 50 on this new game I've been playing that I didn't notice what Brayton was doing to my hair.
Take a look.
Oh, Brayton, what do you do? He butchered my hair and tried to use that stuff. You know what I'm talking about, that black paint.
Brayton.
So on the first day back to school, our teacher was asking us what we did this summer. And what do you do, Desmond?
I play my drums every day.
Good. And what do you do this summer, Brayton?
I wanted to get better at fighting, so I picked up boxing. And guess what? I haven't lost a match yet.
Good for you, Brayton. I bet you're going to kick a lot of butt this year.
Woo! I'm glad me and Brayton passed things up last year.
During recess, we were playing tag in the jungle gym. As I was running, I rushed my tail, and it was Brayton!
Oh, you stepped on my fingers!
Yo, Brayton, it was an accident. I'm sorry.
Nah, I don't want to hear that. You lost my respect.
Well, I mean, if you seen us running around up here, why would you be hanging on the jungle gym?
Oh, so now you want to get smart. I'm going to beat you up after school.
Oh, my goodness. Here we go again. Come on, Brayton. We're in the 8th grade now. Can we just talk about this? He just looked at me and kept on walking. So can you guess what I did? I ran out to school when the bell rung. I never got my bike back from Brayton when he stole it last year, so I had to run all the way home. I guess I got to deal with another year of Brayton.
So I decided that I wasn't going to run away from Brayton, but I can't lie, I was a little bit scared.
I knew you wouldn't show up to fight me yesterday, little punk with your ugly red shirt.
He does know that we all have to wear the same shirt, right?
Oh yeah, you're a little bit new, so you don't even know. A couple of years ago, we were allowed to wear whatever we wanted, but some kids couldn't afford the best clothes, and we, I mean they, would get teased for it.
Yo, Desmond, I got one question. What are those? I mean, really, look at your shoes. Look at your pants. Look at your shirt. Hey, hey, look at your shoes. Look at your pants. Look at your shirt. Everybody, come on.
Look at your shoes. Look at your pants. Look at your shirt.
Hey, hey. Your whole fit is trash. You look ridiculous.
So what did the kids do about it?
They did the only thing they could do. They told the principal, and the next year, we had to wear uniforms.
Oh, so that's why we gotta wear these red shirts. But I like that chant, though. How did it go? Look at your shoes. Look at your pants. Look at your shirt.
I remember that.
Look at your shoes. Look at your pants. Look at your shirt.
So my middle school had this tall gate that surrounded the building. If you were playing outside, you weren't allowed near it, and definitely not on the other side. But one day during recess, I was playing the cat game. A game you go around searching for cute cats. Crazy games on my page. When all of a sudden my friend's eyes said,
have you heard? Brain went on the other side. Nobody has ever gone on the other side.
Yeah.
I had to see it. So no, Brayton was on the other side of the gate, looking crazy as I don't know what. And then he said, Desmond, I dare you to come through the other side.
Actually, you could have turned down a dare no matter how crazy it was. Fine, I'll do it. Brayton came back over and I went in.
Say, he's kind of nice over here.
Oh, teacher, Desmond's on the other side.
No, are you crazy? No one's ever been on the other side.
Yeah, Brayton was over here first and they ain't dare me to.
Now I know Brayton's not that crazy. Desmond, I'm calling your daddy.
Oh, yeah.
So by this age, I was really into music and I wanted to start my own singing group. So I held auditions to find 3 more singers. I found 2 really good singers and all I needed was 1 more.
And what's your name?
Brayton.
I looked up and it was Brayton, the school bully. Brayton, you don't even know how to sing.
I want to sing. And I was like, baby, oh, baby, no.
I'm sorry, Brayton, but you can't be in my group.
You better put me in the group or I'm going to beat you up.
So at our first rehearsal, we were trying to come up with a group name.
The group name should be Brayton and the Dum-Dums. And since my name is Brayton, that makes me the lead singer.
No, this is my group.
The name of the group is Brayton and the Dum-Dums. So it's my group.
Hey, Brayton, since this is your group, shouldn't you be practicing with us?
I don't need to practice, and I don't like your attitude. You out the group.
No! So ever since I was a kid, I had a habit of shaking my legs. Half of the times, I didn't even notice that my legs were shaking, but other people started to notice, and that's when the problem started. Teachers would ask me if I had to go to the bathroom.
Desmond, do you have to go to the bathroom?
No, why?
Because your legs are shaking.
Oh, it's just a habit. My parents started thinking that I was being disrespectful.
I don't care, you're not going outside until you do that homework. Are you trying to be smart?
What did I do?
You're shaking your legs, so you think you're big now?
No, Dad, it's just a habit.
Oh, so you think I'm stupid?
But the worst person who noticed was Brandon. He noticed my legs were shaking in class, and he started a rumor that I brought a frog to school.
Look, everybody, this man's a frog in his pants.
Well, I knew something funny was going on here. No, it's just a habit. I can't help it.
No, I'm not falling for that again. The principal is waiting.
So let me get this straight. You brought a frog to school?
No, I just be shaking my legs.
Well, Brain said he saw this frog, so you know what Brain says goes. I'm sorry, Desmond, my ears is burning. So yesterday, Brayton got me suspended for one day. And anytime I got suspended, I had to stay at my grandparents' house while my parents were at work.
There wasn't a whole lot to do there.
They only had basic cable, so I couldn't watch my favorite shows. The internet wasn't the best, so no YouTube. If I got hungry, they only had Woodles and Noodles. And sometimes, the Woodles and Noodles was expired.
1992!
These noodles are older than me! I got a text message from Brayton. The message said, wait, let me get my Brayton voice.
Look what we're watching in class today.
And then he sent me a video. I clicked on a video, and my whole entire class was looking at the video of me getting beat up by Brayton. I could hear everybody laughing. Even the teacher was laughing. I couldn't believe it. I'm not even at school and Brayton's making a fool out of me.
Look y'all, this is my favorite part.
Now when I go back to school, I'm gonna be a laughingstock. So on my first day back to school after my suspension, Brayton was already there starting.
Oh, look who it is. Little egghead. Why you come back to school? Nobody missed you.
If they need your help, tell the teacher.
Don't kiss me nothing today.
Don't try to make somebody sad.
Get out of my face.
Don't make somebody's face bad.
Why are you picking up my hand though?
Don't try to make somebody cry.
Why you doing what you want?
Don't make somebody hurt inside.
So one day our class was going on a field trip to a museum. We were put into groups, and of course I was in Brayton's group. Our teacher told us to look after one another so that no one would get lost. I could see Brayton grinning, and I knew he was up to something. Anyways, the museum was so fun.
There
were so many cool things to see, but I thought...
I'm not your dad, don't say that.
All of a sudden, Brayton said to me,
I want to see the dinosaur bones, hurry up.
I was so excited, and I followed him.
Dead.
All I see was lying when I looked around, and I was
all alone. I didn't put it, don't say I'm dead.
That was one of my biggest fears ever. I looked at my phone, and I had no service.
I'm all alone. I don't think we're fighting.
Down and found a security guard who brought me back to my group.
You're in big trouble, Desmond. Brain said you ran off and we were looking all over for you. You cannot come to the next church.
So most people don't know that Yermy had a real job. He used to work at my school. Sometimes he'll be picking up trash or wiping down the jungle gym, and he was also the crossing guard.
Yeah, come on!
But Yermy started doing things that ultimately got him fired. Like instead of cleaning the jungle gym, he was playing on it.
Well, yeah, this is what I'm talking about, yeah!
Or when he was helping kids cross the street, he started asking them for $5.
Hey, yo, but let me hold $5.
Final straw was when the principal found Yermy in the bushes.
Yermy, I've been looking all over for you. What are you doing in the bushes? Oh, I'm just playing this new SpongeBob game. I'm having a cook-off.
Oh, I see. But I'm glad you're having fun, because guess what? You're fired.
So, no $5?
You'll get your last paycheck in a...
While my granddaughter is thinking about what's next, it's important she knows about our family's past.
I learned through Ancestry that our ancestors were some of the first Jewish immigrants to come to Canada.
Get to know your family story at Ancestry.ca.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to our channel. Today is a great day because you're going to see top 150 TikTok plus Fortnite moments. Tell us, how often do you use TikTok? And have you tried the new battle royale called Spellbreak? Also, share this video with your friends if you like it. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel and see you soon. Let's get started.
Check.
You know what I thought about?
What's up?
Your life is in my hands right now.
Yeah.
I put a clean doctor on you.
You feel
me? Bro, are you good?
Yeah.
I need the helicopter, and this dude's taking my helicopter. I don't think so, buddy.
Hey, Bill, I'm in the mood for a switch-up. I hit the bunch and hit the road right till I hiccup. I hit the stage and leave with money, that's a sticker. She's fixing purpose, so I told him I'm a flicker.
Ninja, Ninja is a ginger, and a ginger getting punched by a plunger.
At first I said that I love you when you ain't say that shit back. It's kinda hard to just trust you when both your feelings don't match. Got me somewhere less emotions, I don't wanna get attached. Once I give you my word, that's where it ain't no going back. Once I give you my eyes, you better keep that shit intact. Instead of turning no words, girl, I'm just here to stay intact. You want me to take you back?
Ninja, yeah, you might fuck
go to your corner and fucking drive it like
what? You've got big boobs under the waddle. Whose kid is this? I'm gonna go pee on the deep end. Bye.
I'm just a super bot.
I miss all my shots.
If I die a lot, I'm doo-doo.
I can't feel for crap.
And my aim is really whack.
Reboot me and I'll be back. I'm doo doo. Like
you all know, I'm not a little boy, I'm a girl. Just in case you're wondering.
No one asked and no one cares. Are you really a girl? I didn't know girls play video games.
Hello, I am Supercard Player 1995. Welcome.
Son, I have good news and bad news. Which one do you want first? The bad news. I'm dying. Wait, I thought I asked for the bad news first. Hey, yo, what's up? Yo, hello, are you there? Yo, is my mic muted or something? Hello?
I hate this.
Roblox is so fun nowadays, bro. Roblox!
Don't worry about it! I was just playing Roblox with him! Stop that, calm down!
Can we do it?
Jerry!
Oh,
see guys, we don't play Roblox again. Always include others.
I'm pirate speed.
Upset. Is there anything you want to talk about?
Why the fuck is there so many letters in Wednesday?
With 10 speed.
Right
there. And there's a lot of letters. Oh, that shit say Wednesday. It was like
Wednesday.
That's the
point of the day. Then we went 4. Then
we went 2. What me? I'm just one side.
I'm under the water.
Okay.
Gotcha, bitch!
Where the kid is, I need a babysitter. Let me check. I'm pretty sure it was only ringing the doorbell. Hello, is anybody here? Hello? Oh, hi, sir. Yeah, I'm a babysitter.
Alright, make sure she's in bed by 10. I'm gonna be back in 2 hours.
Right? Okay, bye. See you later, sir. I'll take good care of her. Where's she at? Hi, are you here? Oh, hi, I'm a babysitter. Your dad's gonna be gone. Sir, would you like to. What do you want to do while your dad's gone? You want to play Minecraft?
Yeah.
I'm really good at Minecraft. Like, do you want to play, like, right now?
Yeah, like,
right now. But, oh, yeah! I told you I played Minecraft, bro! You played the next time I come over, bro! Minecraft is super important!
You know what time it is? Discord time!
You want to be a long time?
What?
That bad the butt.
I know!
Hey, sweetie, how's school? What's his name?
David.
Gonna go through school?
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
Wait, where are you going?
Daddy's just gonna go for a quick.
Dad, we have a rest, guys. No, please. Want some power?
Let's go.
Love you one.
Yeah, let me go.
You're about
to get finished. That kid's honestly terrible. Look, just look.
21.
Don't
look at the floor. Someone just ordered a package for same day delivery, but it's 11:59.
Ah!
Are you crazy?
H&R Block can still get you a great refund.
I need to cool down. Mind if I short circuit?
I'm looking for the whole family here.
I need the night off. They'll understand.
Oh, please, I
guess you're ordering in.
What? Excuse me, the bell did not dismiss you either.
You know what, Miss Carrie? Yes, that's my bad.
Then what the fuck is the battle for?
Yes, a legendary chest. I'll probably get a pistol if I open it. Hey, Dad, come over here and open this chest for me.
Why do you want me to do it?
I always have bad luck when I open these. Maybe if you open it, I'll get something good.
Oh, all right. Well, here goes nothing.
Bruh.
Did you
find
me,
dude? Did you find me, dude? I have my gun, Tony.
No, wait.
I'm dead, bro. Yeah, she got it, bro.
Fucking
gold. Team, bro. Now, go. Transformers. Trans activated. How does she one pump with that?
Let's go, pussy.
What?
Let's go, pussies. Come
oh
on, bitches. Y'all both want to come at me?
Wait, what? Johnny, bro, we gotta team, bro. Yeah, we have to team, bro. We have to. Watch out.
Come on, bitches.
sing
Sing!
I'm a banana!
You're a what?
I'm a banana!
Nothing
is close. I'm a banana!
I'm a banana! I'm a banana! I'm a banana!
Papdushka's land.
Good. You should know. It's almost better, guys.
Hey, did you call our neighbor Mrs. Johnson a bitch?
Hey, John?
Yeah! She changed the Wi-Fi password!
You guys want to sleep at grandma's
tonight? That bitch changed the Wi-Fi password!
Yeah?
Hey, yo, hello?
Hi!
Yeah, hi!
You want to sleep at grandma's?
How are you?
I'm playing!
You're playing?
Jay, you want to sleep at grandma's too?
No.
Yeah?
No.
Well, it's bed. You hear me? Do you move away? Bella, you better not fucking team anywhere or I'll fucking punch you in the head. Move.
Mom.
Hmm.
I think I got 2 kills. I'm sweating. I'm okay now. I'm chilling. I do not want to die.
No!
I'm flying.
These might be knocking.
Guys, when I'm done sweeping, it's bed, eh? Cameron?
Stop freaking laser by your dummy head.
Laser. Stop talking like that. Pee can?
No. I'm not scared. I'm
it's midnight. Oh, stress as hell. This sounds like speedy.
And it's Betty.
Five.
We could go upstairs.
Minutes. Then it's done. Just stop it. Like, it's not funny. And I don't like it. And don't rain me yet. Like, I'm giving him started, bro.
Let's start a game. And it's two and a down block to this beyond the down block.
I gotta put the in. I gotta walk.
A god.
Are you a god? Oh, I'm a boy.
You're going to
weep.
Oh,
Bella.
You are you saying to me?
You're a god.
I'm a god, your boy. I can't stand this.
Ken!
I see the puddle door! The puddle ball?
Dad, look at the puddle door.
School? Do not go in there. Do not. Do actually do not.
That's the puddle door's house.
Okay, but don't go in there. The disgusting zombies.
You can't go up this mouth.
Show me the bigger way.
And you fucking kill the rat.
Bobby? Run away. But come to my house and run. It's too much people. Take a call and run over people. I like it. I'm taking a call. Oh! There's no gas. Run. You can run me over. Bobby's hide. Camera slide.
Ah!
Run away.
Ah.
Run. Run.
Ah!
Fly! One top of this house. Ah! Somebody's home! Yo!
Ow! Ow!
Where to be? Where you want to be? Where you need to be?
Run in!
Do you have a med kit?
No. It has to be?
On 9 it's be. I'm saving
I'm on 10th be! I'm 10th be.
Then 2.
There's not more there.
There's people there?
Yes.
Whoa. Oh, go.
Can't come to me.
I got. Get the fuck away.
Come to me, Cam.
You take the gun. Loyo. I'm coming!
No!
Oh no.
Come! Come, Bobby!
I was trying to call you up!
Bobby, just crouch and come! Crouch!
I was right here.
Okay, I don't care. Just come! Crouch, Bobby! Yes. Go! We're obviously going to the right way. Come on, escape, Bobby. Come on, Timmy. Go to your face now. No. There's no way you will make it, wait.
No!
Buddy up again. Buddy up.
Oh! beautiful girl. I'm gonna call you Zephyr, the wolf. I'm gonna call you Zephyr, the girl. Zephyr, the girl.
Bobby, no, you're not calling me nobody.
I'm calling you
Bobby, I'm not your friend.
Yo.
You fucking ass! Bobby, okay, Joe, Dad's gonna come.
I never went away.
Run away. Guns. Oh, people think I failed. Turn to an emoji. Me. Oh, we followed you. Yeah. I have 100 health. I can't see my health. Oh, now I can see it. Turn to. Don't.
I know. Stop.
Okay, but when you die, I'm not gonna save you.
Wanna go to the water?
Bobby, no, come back. Bobby, come back. I'm really not joking.
I'm going on top of a building.
I can see where I'm at.
I'm talking
about. Come on.
Oh, but Bobby!
Bobby, just come here screaming. But people are there. But I wanna go over there over with you.
Nobody's there.
But someone's big for the top. Okay, you're gonna die.
I'm out. I'm not going there.
I'm waiting your one all the times.
I'm flying.
Can you saw somebody there?
Yep.
Sleep
I saw that crack. I saw that crack.
Okay, I'm putting it on the big pot. Sorry, you took the bullets. Boy! Ah! I'm kidding. One. I'm down.
Ah, oh my gosh! No!
Bobby, hide! Bobby, move your butt!
I'm on top of the building!
Is it cracked? Is it man cracked?
I didn't saw them!
Oh my god, be quiet! I'm gonna save
no!
You. I'm gonna be saving Mr. Wolfpump, okay? I'm not saving you. Die.
Stop.
Just turn off your game.
Stop.
Soon.
I'm gonna go to grandma.
You wanna go to grandma's?
Yes.